What's up, Rayquazers? So, I actually have a Thieves Guild match here. And if you don't know, Thieves Guild is my guild on a group called Dark Wars. I'll leave a link in the description in case you want to join. But yeah, you need to, of course, be like pretty epically awesome and all that and blah, blah, blah. And all that good stuff. But yeah, so this is actually Scrafty Swag. You guys probably know him because I battled him. This is Scrafty Swag's actual video match, and yeah, you'll see what happens in this match. I'm not going to ruin anything for you. I'm not going to spoil it, but we'll show you. All right, so he's going to lead off with Infernape, and his opponent's going to lead off with Amoongus, and basically going to withdraw their Amoongus, fearing the Flare Blitz or Fire Punch or something like that, and then of course go into Politoed to resist that, as Infernape goes for the taunt, and then the Stealth Rocks, because this Infernape has Focus Sash, so basically he can resist, or I mean he can survive any hit. And I noticed that even though it might be Specs or it might not be, judging by the damage, it's probably, chances are, not Specs, especially since it just switched moves. And I noticed that 3-attack Politoed is starting to become increasingly common. Strangely enough, instead of the usual defensive variety. Maybe that's because of the new stuff that's out. I'm not really sure. But he's going to bring in Lucario because, yeah, Nasty Plot and obvious Focus Sash is obvious. So, even though Focus Blast hits, the Lucario hangs on thanks to Focus Sash. And all that good stuff. And now Lucario's gonna go for the Aura Spear because obviously it outspeeds this Politoed. And that gets rid of a Politoed. And like I said, it's kind of crazy how three attack Politoed's becoming increasingly popular. So the Vacuum Wave goes. And yeah, he gets hit by Hurricane. I'm not really sure what Tornadus this is right now. I'm gonna guess some kind of, looks like a Life Orb set, but I don't know if it's Tornadus T or not. He is going to withdraw, though, so maybe it is, maybe it's not. We'll see when it comes back in. But, so, Keldeo's going to come in, of course, because, you know, that Secret Sword. And Absol really doesn't really care because Focus Sash, look at that. And, going to go for the Psycho Cut and get rid of the Keldeo, which is great. See you later, Keldeo. And that is a dead Keldeo. Now Jirachi's going to come in. And, obvious attack is obvious, so Sucker Punch. And, it does, like, a massive amount of damage to the Jirachi. It's kind of insane, honestly. And, yeah, clearly some kind of Parafusion Jirachi is my guess. So Starmie's gonna come in and go for the Surf, because the rain will boost the Surf, which is good. And now, freaking Haxorus, look at this. And the only reason a Haxorus would come in on a Starmie is if it's Scarfed. I mean, look at that. That was an insanely high amount of damage. Now Scyther's gonna show up and try and tank this Outrage because of Eviolite. But unfortunately, it's not gonna be able to revenge kill the Haxorus. And so the Scyther goes down. That was the best bet for Scrafty Swag to actually survive and do anything, and of course switch out into an Amoongus because, yeah, obviously can. Don't know why exactly, because Bug Buzz, you know, kind of would hit anything on the team hard, and yeah, go for the Bug Buzz and gets put to sleep. And of course, unfortunately, Scrafty Swag is not going to wake up, which means that his opponent wins. Tornadus comes in, and since it's not rehealed, it's not obviously the regenerator set. And because Scrafty Swag did not wake up, Galvantula goes down, sadly. And crit doesn't really matter. But that is going to be the guild match. This was before his scores were reset, though, so like, we're actually winning. So, see ya.